Hey there! In this video, we're going to talk about how you can build a funnel visualization in Looker Studio so that you better understand your conversion or drop-off rates. We're going to cover how to create funnels using community visualization charts or how to reduce the data load through a simple table chart funnel. Let's start with the community visualizations. Whether you have an e-commerce shop or you sell services, your customers go through multiple stages before buying something from you. Sales, marketing, survey, cancellation funnels, depending on how you want to improve your customer's experience, you might choose to monitor stages, journey step levels, website pages, and so on. The most commonly used funnels are the marketing or sales funnels. Today, we are going to presume you have an e-commerce store and you have already implemented Google Analytics 4. Now you want to visualize how your users are flowing through the different stages of the funnel and what is the conversion rate for the final transaction number. So from product view to transaction. Currently, there isn't an inbuilt ready-to-use funnel chart, so the first way in which you can do this is through community visualization charts. Let's take a look at the third-party charts available. If we go to the visualization library and search for funnel, you'll see that there are two charts available. We're going to cover one of these two, the one from Aima, and another one that is not visible here. Let's dig into it. We'll start with the free community viz from Aima. Thank you for making this great resource available, by the way. We'll go into edit mode, and then here on the menu bar, we have the community visualizations and components. So we click here and we click on explore more, and we will search for the funnel. And we have it here. We can click and drag it anywhere on the dashboard, but we already added it and configured it. So let's go through our scenario. We want to see how our users went from viewing our products to adding them to the cart and then buying them. So if we click on the chart, we will have the setup menu open up to the right. And in the metrics section here, we will add the ones that are of interest to us in a high to low order. So we have the item views, add to carts, transactions. What I mean by that is that we know that the first step is for people to take a look at an item, then add it to the cart. Reversing the order, for example, by dragging the item views in the middle, will not only make my funnel look unnatural, but it also incorrectly reflects the flow of the user through the website. So make sure to add your metrics in the correct order. Now that we define the metrics, these numbers won't tell us too much. So we will go to style, where I won't talk about the actual styling of the chart. You can, of course, customize your preferred colors, your fonts, your backgrounds here. But you can also find the most important feature of this chart here in the computed values section. What are these and what is their function? If we enable them, these two will show you your conversion rates from one step to the other, so percentage versus previous, and from one step to the initial step, percentage versus initial. So the value that is in the bottom right corner will always tell you the conversion rate from the first step to the last, even if you have 10 steps in between. In our case, from product view to transaction, we have a 171% conversion rate. But what if you want to monitor more events, not just these three predefined GA4 ones? Is there another option? Luckily, there is, and it's another free community viz that I'm grateful for. It looks like this, and it's from TrueMetrics. As you've seen, this one is not available in the official visualization library. You will not see it here. So how can you add it to your dashboard? This can be done actually in a similar way in which we added the previous funnel chart, by going in edit mode on this community visualizations and components button on the menu bar, and then explore more, but this time click on build your own visualization. Obviously, we're not developers, so we're not going to start building our own charts right now, but fortunately, the people that are have been generous to share their work with us, and we can use it by adding a manifest path in this field right here. The manifest for our funnel graph, if we go back to the TrueMetrics article, you will see that we have it here, so we copy this, and we paste it back in our dashboard. We submit, and you will see that it appears right below the manifest path. Select it and place it wherever you want in your dashboard. As usual, we already did that, so let's jump directly to how we can set it up. I'm going to select the chart, and we have this parameters section here where we will want all our event names. In the metrics section, we can either select event count or total users, but I'm gonna select total users because I think it's more useful to look at it this way. Also, keep in mind that sorting matters for this chart too. So if I sort, for example, by event name, it won't be too much of a funnel. So make sure you select by total users in a descending way. But now I have too many events in the funnel, as you can see, way too many. And it doesn't help me understand how many users are actually navigating my website and how they are doing this. So what I want to do is filter out by my main five events. I will go to the filter section, and I already created a filter that contains my main five events. If I select on editing it, you will see that these are view item, add to cart, add shipping info, add payment, and then the purchase. So when I apply it, it will make things much clearer and cleaner. And if I want an even cleaner look, because right now, as you can see, the events have this unfriendly format with view item add to cart written with the underlines, I can go and create a new field. So if I go here and I create a new field and I paste this case when formula, which says, okay, if I have view item, please write it as product view. If I have add to cart, write it like this, and so on, much more clean. Apply, and you will see here the renaming. Same as with the previous chart, when we go to style, we have direction settings, so if you want, you can direct it vertically or horizontally. I prefer horizontally. Same with the gradients, you have the option to edit your colors and your fonts, but there's also an important feature that you don't want to miss. It's this display sublabel check that we want to enable because it will show us the drop-off rates, as you can see. The parameters format is not available publicly, so the default is the drop-off. We don't have the others, like for example, the conversion rates, but I still find it really useful. Please note that this is the drop-off that happens at each steps level and not from one step to the next. So for example, on the add to cart level, 70% or more of the users don't move forward. I recommend that you add a tooltip with this information. So here, if I go to view, I added a tooltip where I tell the people that use the dashboard, the client or the stakeholders, so that they are aware that the drop-off rate refers to the drop-offs happening at that specific step and not relative to the previous or initial step, as we've seen with this AIMA chart. Also, if you want to calculate either conversion or drop-off rates from one step to the other, you will need to create data blends between the steps that you're interested in. So between product view and add to cart, if I go here, I'll have a blend between the add to carts and the item views with their respective filters. So in this case, we have a 21% conversion rate from item view to add to cart and a 78% drop rate from item view to add to cart. However, if you want to avoid blending the data 10 times, which also means a faster loading time for your dashboard, reaching quotas and so on, and you prefer a simple setup, you can use a regular table chart from Looker Studio. No video without giving credit to the right people, so it's important to mention that this method is another one of Medi's. You can find it here, we will share the link with you. This method will require a couple of calculated fields and one simple data blend. Firstly, let's select our chart. Let's go to our GA4 sample data and add a new field, which we'll call funnel step. So we have this sample data here. We go to add a field. We will add a new field, which we'll call funnel step. I have the name right here. So this will be my name. And then the formula will be a case when formula that assigns a value from 1 to 5, an order to each step. We saved the formula, but we already saved this one because we used it in a blend with itself. So I will cancel here and then I will go to the blend that we already built. So let's analyze how it is built. This funnel step here, it's the same as this funnel step here, but we renamed the one in the first column. So you can see it's funnel step and final step here as well. But we renamed this one so that it's easier to know which one is which in a formula we'll use later. Then we have the event name. Then in the metrics section, we want the total users that we renamed total users by step. So it's the same one with this one here. And we renamed for the same reason as before. And also don't forget the main five events filter and the cross join operator. Main five events filter on the right too. Save your blend, we already did that. So the table will have the event name as a dimension, and as metrics, let's take them one by one. We will have the total users, and if we click on edit, we will see that we have none selected in the comparison calculation. Then we have the conversion rate percentage versus the initial step, which is actually the same metric as above, total users by step. But in the comparison calculation dropdown, we selected percentage of max relative to corresponding data. And the third metric is the drop-off percentage versus the previous step. It's an if formula that looks like this, and we will share it in the video notes. Last but not least, make sure your chart type is a table with bars. And if we go to style, select in the first metrics column bar. So we scroll and we have column metrics, column number one, we select bar and then show number. Columns two and three can just be numbers. From the missing data dropdown, show a blank or a dash so that we don't have an ugly null at the top. That was it, folks. Let me know if you found this video useful and if you're going to start monitoring your website's funnel stages. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.
All right, thanks Andreea for this great information. If this video helped you out in any way, then hit that like button. And also check out this playlist right over here where we have more interesting topics on Data Studio and data visualization. Now from everybody here at Measure School, happy measuring.